Welcome to Earl Stewart on Cars with Earl and Nancy Stewart. Reach them with your questions at 877-960-9960.
Ladies, let me ask you a question. What do you think? When you walk into the dealership, why on so many occasions do you get asked, "Where's your husband? Did you talk to your boyfriend?" Ladies, how do you feel about that? Do you realize the chances of that sale just dropping to zero and that woman walks away? Without a doubt, women make financial decisions on everything. Women make up a huge part of purchasing a car. I can't emphasize it enough. Maybe you were talked into some add-on features when you were in the service department. Give us a call with your stories. Your calls are very important. 877-960-9960. We're going to go to Lori, who is calling us from Tamarack. Welcome to the show, Lori.
Hi, how are you all doing today? The reason I'm calling, what Nancy was saying about females going to dealerships, I am not an expert on cars. I never claim to be, but I have a general idea as to what to ask, what to look for, or whatever. Mm-hmm. And what you were saying about people going to dealerships, many, many years ago, I went into a dealership. My brother-in-law had a deal for me on a car, but he said, you know, it's similar. You know, I can't take you to the dealership right now. He was working. Why don't you go in and just, you know, try the car out and see, and if you like it, you know, I can get you a deal on it. I went into a dealership, and I said, I'd like to, you know, see the car. I'd like to test drive it. You know what they said to me? Well, unless you're going to buy today, you can't test drive it.
Oh.
I said, excuse me? Yeah. And they said, no, you know, it wasn't a rainy day. It wasn't a busy day. It wasn't a holiday weekend. The guy would not let me test drive the bloody car unless I was going to say I would buy it that day. So I said, okay. To let you know, every time I go by that dealership, I hear it advertised. Let's just say I say a few curse words. I will never deal with anybody in that area for that dealership. Not to mention, I've told other people about that dealership not to even go there. I don't care if they changed owners 75 times, mm-hmm. or management or salesman.
Well, Lori, that is amazing. And you know, what the car dealers do to themselves, it's amazing how they survive. And by the way, feel free to mention the name of the dealership if you feel more comfortable not to mention. I can say.
Oh, I don't mind mentioning it. As I said, it was University Dodge.
University Dodge. Yeah, it's hard. It's hard to believe. And sometimes it's the salesperson, but it's still the dealership's responsibility. You could say there's always a rotten apple in the barrel, maybe so, but you always hold the owner of the dealership responsible. And something like that is just insulting. What I have been advising women to do when they go into car dealerships is to ask to speak to a woman salesperson. And one of the problems the car dealers have is they have very few women salespeople. Some car dealers don't have any women. And if car dealers heard more customers, especially the women coming in, asked to speak to another woman, that would encourage them to hire more, and it would be a really nice. Not only would it help the women who want to buy cars, it would help a lot of women that would like to have jobs in car dealerships. You walk into a typical car dealership, less than 1 in 10 employed is a woman. We find in our dealership, Lori, that not only do the women prefer to speak to women salespeople, but so do the men. You know, women. Women are different than men. Anybody tells you that's not true is crazy. We have about a third of our sales force is women. We wish we had half. I've often said I wish I had 100% woman sales force, because the women are more understanding and empathetic and listen better. And that's what buyers want to do. They want someone to listen to their needs and try to fulfill them.
You know, maybe my opinion is just a little bit different than Earl's, but I entertain the idea of walking into a dealership if I had to either deal with a man or a woman. I have no preference. My preference is this. If you and I don't click, I simply turn around and I leave.
So that's true.
Hopefully that'll be helpful to you or any of the women who are listening. That kind of advertisement that comes from you is worth its weight in gold. You just don't realize how many people that you reach at that moment when those words come out of your mouth and you speak to another woman or another man. It doesn't matter. And guess what? That kind of advertisement is worth more than those billboards that you see on 95. That word spreads rapidly. And for that, I thank you. I thank you for letting your voice be heard.
Hi, this is Earl Stewart. Thank you for watching this video. If you would like to be notified of new videos that we post to our YouTube channel, simply click on the subscribe button at the lower right-hand side of the screen.